We'll be right back. Cut You Down album. You've probably heard that song, and it's called Shaken. And we recorded it a couple times in different ways, but that's probably my most favorite way to play is when we're just like going all out. Mm-hmm. So for me, at least, it's fun.
It's not a pop song. You know?
So, and I'm glad some people are wearing earplugs. I'm not. But it's more fun to do it that way. But yeah, it's definitely on, if I remember right, Our Guy's Gonna Cut You Down album. It's on another one that I'm forgetting right now, but we've recorded more ones. But they also use that for the basketball team, the Portland Trailblazers, when the basketball players come onto the court. So that's been a fun way to get some jazz into more mainstream, I guess, consciousness without having to change the way we play. I think that's always the thing, because especially like a decade ago, I played on a bunch of different pop things, and I always felt kind of weird about it, because if you have to change the way that you want to play because someone's telling you to, even if the records sell millions of copies, it's a weird feeling as an artist. So probably about 10 years ago or so, I'm just like, regardless, even if it means not getting some of those, you know, gigs or whatnot, I don't want to do anything that I don't feel 100% about musically. So that's kind of, that definitely holds true with that last song, Shaken. Next, I think we're going to play something that features John. And I hope you all like this one. It's a fun standard. I used to get to play it nightly when I was in Tony Bennett's band. But John has a really cool way of playing it. We have our little Chicago-style ending. And I think you all know this one, Fly Me to the Moon.
pleasure to be here. Madison's a great town. It's great to be with these wonderful musicians. Frank and I have known each other since the Barrett Deans days. I don't know if you know what Barrett Deans was. But he was a drummer, played with Louis Armstrong, and Benny Goodman. And he was known to make coffee nervous. he was one of those guys that wore a bunch of watches on his hands, and he was billed as world's fastest drummer. And it was incredible because when I was 15, I went down to Marina City and I sat in, and for some reason he liked me, I guess. And he started letting me play with all these great musicians. So I started playing with like bass players like Duke Groner, all these people that had played with Duke Ellington. And you know, I had long hair, I looked like this, except better. And you know, so I got a chance to play. So finally, as Barrett got older and older, he had a big band, and I played, and I met Frank. And when he died, his wife, Jane, asked me to take over the band, but I said, man, there's no way I'm gonna take over Barrett Deans, because he was really a character. You know, he'd go on the radio, what was that one story? He didn't like the drums. He's live on like WGN radio with ice fucking drums. He was really, really crazy. It was great. And so then when we did this record, Topics of Conversation, it was a friend of ours that is a big wig at Shure Microphones, which was starting a studio. So Frank and I just went in and we couldn't even see each other. We played, it was recorded in like 1 or 2 days, right? We played and it's like it's some of the funnest playing that I've ever had. We just had such a great time. And so since then, I mean, we've been great friends, and we just have fun, as you can tell. I mean, I don't even know these songs. I mean, and then playing with John and Oliver is just so fun, to, you know, just to kind of have groove and have fun at this point. Because now I'm a tenured professor at Roosevelt University, and I play a lot of different types of music, but this is like always with Frank, we just kind of blow it on out. You know, and we have some CDs. I have actually a book back there too. You have a book back there too.
Yeah, I only have one, but Hal Leonard just put out one of my saxophone technique books. So I have like one singular over there. I think you have more than one book.
I have one book back there.
I have one and copy of.
Well, what's weird is because, you know, I've never cared what people thought of it, really. And so I wrote this book about playing backbeats on 1/3. I don't know if you know what that means, but you know when you go to a country western bar and everyone's clapping on the 1/3, you know, instead of 1, 2, 3, 4, like 1, 2, and people would laugh at that. And I thought, wait a second, you know, there's a million books, million songs, everything. All the backbeats on the snare drum are always on 2 and 4. And like, why is this? Because Sunshine Your Love by Cream is actually turned around. And there's a couple other songs like that, not many of them. Bell Bottom Blues by Derek and the Dominoes did that. But I wrote this book, and like it's really funny because I'm afraid to always do it because once you do it and people don't know, if they don't know you're doing it, it sounds like you turn the beat around, which is really funny. So I'm kind of reluctant to do it. Maybe we can do kind of a fun thing and I'll kind of I'll mess it up. Because you're going to hear things normally and they're going to be inverted. And that's my book. And then there's a couple other CDs back there too. Well, can we try something where, you know?
I say let's do we'll do Big Al's theme. Okay.
What's that?
it's a 2 and 4 funk song.
Okay, so it's not
so
a 1
you can
three.
Do your 1 and 3.
Okay. Okay. So I won't laugh at you clap on 1 and 3 because before we go, I went to see Zakir Hussain and Dave Holland. So, you know, they were playing with these amazing Indian musicians. And so half the audience, if not more, were all Indian people. And, you know, they can hear these meters and 7 and 13 and come in and write. And so they play this one song and they go, well, we're going to play a song that you all know, you know. And so they start playing and the entire audience was clapping on 1 and 3. And went, maybe I'm onto something. Because if they can feel things on 1 and 3, you know, why not? So, you know, we'll see what happens.
Well, Paul also, you know, can pretty much, you know, play 1, 3, 2, and 4, only 4, like, all these different things. So let's see how many things he throws out at us and see if I can figure it out for myself. But this song we wrote in honor of the doorman at the Green Mill. Again, I mentioned Green Mill earlier, but since I've been 16 years old, I've been regularly playing there. And if you ever go there, the doorman's name is Big Al,
oh, yeah.
And he's got the handlebar mustache, from the whole
show. Yeah. Yes.
We all know Big Al.
I know Big.
Big Al fan.
I mean, Big Al definitely is a very cool guy. So this is Big Al's theme.
This is like not too fast, right?
No, this would be like for what you're talking
cool.
about.
Cool, right.
Thank you.
president, you might as well bring back the one and three.
That didn't go over as well. Another nice round of applause for our reporter on the page. Only about once a year do I get to play Madison, so I look forward to when that happens very much every year. And Paul and I were saying that as we were driving up. But over the next couple weeks, we have a bunch of concerts in New York, three shows in Seattle at Tula's. Paul has a cool thing that I can't be at, but I wanted to, at Reggie's. Halloween show at Birdland in New York, that'll be really fun. We just got back from Spain, did a bunch of festivals, so this has been a pretty gangbustery fun year, and we appreciate getting to share it with all you very much. Thank you. That's going to be our last song of the night, but I'm feeling like playing a Stanley Turrentine song, if that's okay. This is Stanley Turrentine's song, Sugar.
All right.